Hey guys, it's Andre from the High Performance Academy. We're here with Ziggy from Zeitronix, and we just wanted to talk to Ziggy about one of their new ethanol content analyzers. Now, Zeitronix are no strangers to ethanol content analyzers. They've already been awarded SEMA awards for their existing ethanol content analyzer. Now, with cars these days running more and more setups with flex fuel, it's really important to understand the content of ethanol in your fuel system, and Zeitronix have made that nice and easy. So, first of all, Ziggy, can you tell us about the sensor that's being used? What's the output from that particular sensor, and how does it tell your computer or your system what the ethanol content is?
The ethanol content sensor outputs a frequency and a duty cycle signal, which unfortunately is not understandable to most ECUs. However, we do have a ECA-2 which takes the signal from that sensor and does output a 0.5 volt analog signal proportional to the ethanol content, 0 volt being 0%, 5 volt being 100% ethanol.
So you're basically taking a frequency input from the ethanol content sensor, and then internally you're turning that signal into the analog output, which is then scaled accordingly, correct?
That is absolutely correct. Moreover, we add an output for the fuel temperature. So when you have a cold start issue, so you can also tie that into the ECU, either in the aftermarket or stock in the place of your coolant temp, intake temp sensor, just to cover the cold start and adjust your fuel timing maps accordingly to get this car going right off the bat.
So you've already won awards for your existing ethanol content analyzer. So can you tell us about what your new product is? What's different?
We're really pleased SEMA awarded us twice for our previous ECA. And we have a new version of it, which basically replaces the old one to the extent, doesn't have a gauge, doesn't have to show you a number, but it ties the sensor into this aftermarket or stock ECU. So it's all about this analog voltage output, although if you wish, you can tie it a gauge, which we offer, and kind of come back into the older setup, functionality, and cover both bases. So the ECU gets a signal, can understand, and you get a number you can understand.
So I take it, we've seen a lot of customers or a lot of people around the world have been using the Zeitronix ethanol content analyzer, installing it along with a flex fuel capable ECU such as maybe the Haltech or the EQTech setup, and in that installation it's not really critical for the person driving the car to see what the ethanol content's amount is. So this is to take that away. Basically, I'm assuming you've cut the cost of the product down a little bit and taken that display out of the equation, yes?
That's absolutely correct. And the end of the day, quite often the driver driving down the mountain doesn't really care what is in the tank. However, the tuner does, or even more important, quite often the shops which tune the cars on the dyno, they would like to know what the customer comes in the tank. Doesn't have to be 85. Not sure what's happening in New Zealand, but we've seen here variations of E40 to E92, where E85 tune being having an aggressive timing and quite often a lot of positive manifold pressure. When if you end up with E40 or E50, you're definitely in trouble. So it's a wonderful fuel, but you really need to know what's in the tank at a given time, either just for the ECU to adjust the timing and the fuel maps, or even for you to check what the gas station is giving you in a given day.
I think there's two sides to that as well. Yes, there's definitely a variation in the ethanol content that's coming in the fuel straight from the fuel stations. And the other problem we see is where people are running two different types of fuel. Maybe they've got a tune for pump fuel and then they've got a separate tune for E85. If you're changing to that E85, you may end up with some pump fuel left in the tank, effectively diluting your ethanol content. So the ECA will tell you exactly where you are, or at least this one will tell your ECU.
That's absolutely correct. Empty fuel tank may hold as much as 2.5 gallons of regular gas, regular petrol. So if you get E70, which is completely legal, you may end up with something like E60, E62, and that may not suit your aggressive tune. You can end up in big trouble. We've seen another problem once in a while when it's not an E70, E85 mix, but unfortunately the fuel tanker trucks, they have the same fitting for all the pipes coming off the ground. So once in a while, mistakes happen, and we've seen the fuel from a tanker truck, regular petrol, being dumped into the E85 inlet. At least that's what we suspect when we see E40. We wouldn't blame the refinery to blend E40, but most likely what happened, basically wrong fuel end up in the wrong hose.
So these new ethanol content analyzers without the display, what's the price point for that product?
It's about $190 for ECA-2, and if you want to kit it with the sensors and the gauge, it's about $370 street price.
Great product. Thanks for taking the time to talk to us. We'll let you get back to it.
Thank you very much for your time. I appreciate it. We'll see you at SEMA next year.
For online tuning courses, visit learntotune.com.